The thing about being famous is that people usually know a lot about your private life, especially being a famous NBA player. This title comes with great responsibilities. It's very easy to mess up a reputation, and sometimes it's even harder to get back on your feet. In today's video, we will be talking about NBA players' most controversial moments that got revealed. The first person we will be talking about is Donald Sterling. The owner of the Los Angeles Clippers has always been very outspoken, sometimes in a very bad way. There have been a couple of times he has used some racial slurs. Many of you may not know that, but he was actually federally prosecuted for being a racist. He was accused of using such comments against his mistress. So, here is exactly what he said. "It bothers me a lot that you want to broadcast that you're associating with black people. And also, I'm just saying, in your lousy Instagrams, you don't have to have yourself walking with black people." He did not stop there, and added, "You can sleep with black people. You can bring them in. You can do whatever you want. The little I ask you is not to promote it on that, and not to bring them to my games." Obviously, this kind of attitude is unacceptable, and in 2014, even Barack Obama spoke about this matter when he was conducting a news conference in Malaysia. With respect to the statements by the owner of the Los Angeles Clippers for our Malaysian audience, this is a sports team, basketball team in the United States. The owner is reported to have said some incredibly offensive racist statements that were published. I don't think I have to interpret those statements for you, they kind of speak for themselves. When ignorant folks want to advertise their ignorance, you don't really have to do anything, you just let them talk. And that's what happened here. I'm confident that the NBA commissioner, Adam Silver, a good man, will address this. Obviously, the NBA is a league that is beloved by fans all across the country. It's got an awful lot of African-American players. It's steeped in African-American culture, and I suspect that the NBA is going to be deeply concerned in resolving this. I'll make just one larger comment about this. The United States continues to wrestle with a legacy of race and slavery and segregation that's still there. The vestiges of discrimination. We've made enormous strides, but you're going to continue to see this percolate up every so often. And I think that we just have to be clear and steady in denouncing it, teaching our children differently, but also remaining hopeful that part of why some statements like this stand out so much is because there's been the shift in how we view ourselves. The next person we'll be talking about is Tim Hardaway. A famous NBA player has been criticized for making homophobic comments on a couple of occasions. It especially got heated in 2007, and he faced a lot of negative backlash because of that. So, here's what he said in 2007. "You know, I hate gay people, so I let it be known. I don't like gay people and I don't like to be around gay people. I am homophobic. I don't like it. It shouldn't be in the world or in the United States." He was also asked in an interview whether he would accept a gay player on his team. Here's how he responded. "First of all, I wouldn't want him on my team. And second of all, if he was on my team, I would, you know, really distance myself from him because, I don't think that's right. And you know, I don't think he should be in the locker room while we're in the locker room. I wouldn't even be a part of that." Obviously, he was canceled after that. David Stern, NBA commissioner, banished Tim from All-Stars in LA. He said, "It is inappropriate for him to be representing us given the disparity between his views and ours." This is an issue overall that has fascinated America. It's not an NBA issue. This is a country that needs to talk about this issue, he said. And not surprisingly, they use sports as a catalyst to begin the dialogue. Hardaway apologized after that couple of times, but his past is definitely what is keeping him from the Hall of Fame. Here's what he had to say. "Well, you know, the reason I'm not in is because of what I said in 2007 about gay people. That's why I'm not in right now. And I understand it. I hurt a lot of people's feelings and it came off the wrong way, and it was really bad of me to say that. Since then, I've turned a wrong into a right. My parents used to always tell me, if you do something wrong, look it in the eye. Don't back down from it and be scared of it. Go make it right and make people understand that you made a mistake. And that's what I did. I'm trying to do what's right, supporting gay people and transgender people. I want people to understand what they go through and understand them as people. They shouldn't be seen as others. You shouldn't call them derogatory names or look at them all ugly. Those are people too. They should get to live their lives just like we live our lives. And that means having freedom and having fun. They should get to enjoy their life the way they're supposed to enjoy life, I've talked to people from the LGBTQ community, and I tell them, you're supposed to have the same rights that we have, and supposed to be able to do everything that we do. You shouldn't be an outcast. Life is too short to be out here hating one another, and trying to hurt one another. I understand that now. But yeah, that's the only reason why I'm not in the Hall of Fame, and I understand that. There's nothing I can do about it. You got to take your bumps and bruises, and that's what I've been doing. I just try to be positive. It hurts. But hey, I understand the ramifications of what I said. I understand why I'm not in. All I can do is keep living. My parents also always told me, you can't control what you can't control. And finally, we will talk about Tim Donaghy. The famous NBA player was widely loved by fans, but when he was caught in gambling and betting activities, fans instantly got angry. It's safe to say that this NBA scandal is one of the biggest of all time. You may not be surprised, but he got canceled after that. Here's a statement from the NBA about this matter. The Tim Donaghy matter concluded over a decade ago with a full investigation by the federal government. Donaghy's termination from the NBA and his conviction for criminal acts. At the same time, at the request of the NBA, former prosecutor Larry Petowitz conducted an independent investigation of Donaghy's misconduct and issued publicly a 133-page report. This report was based on an extensive review of game data and video, as well as approximately 200 interviews, thousands of pages of documents, and consultation with various gambling and data experts. The ESPN article attempts to revive this old story. Unfortunately, it is replete with errors, beginning with its statement that the Petowitz report concluded that Donaghy, in fact, did not fix games. The Petowitz report made no such conclusion. Rather, the investigation found no basis to disagree with the finding of the FBI and the U.S. Attorney's Office that there is no evidence that Donaghy ever intentionally made a particular ruling during a game in order to increase the likelihood that his gambling pick would be correct. ESPN ignores this important distinction. The new material that ESPN has assembled to support its own conclusion that Donaghy manipulated games is not strong and adds little to the existing record. RJ Bell of pregame.com looked into the details of the 2005 and 2007 seasons and said, the first 15 games of the 2006 to 2007 refereed by Tim Donaghy that had big enough bets to move the point spread by at least 1.5 points were undefeated against Las Vegas, meaning that the big money gamblers won a 15 of 15 times on his games. The odds of that happening randomly are 32,768-1, said RJ Bell of pregame.com. Tim Donaghy's officiating style statistically changed during the 2005 to 2006 and 06 to 07 seasons. During the 2 years prior, i.e. 03 and 04 and 04 and 05, he called significantly less fouls than the average NBA referee. His game scored more than Las Vegas expected only 44% of the time. During his last two seasons, he called significantly more fouls than average. His game scored more than Las Vegas expected 57% of the time. The odds of this change happening randomly are approximately 19 to 1. On this note, we end our video. These were just some examples of the NBA players whose controversial moments got revealed. There are way more of them, though. We'd like to know your opinion about the video. What was the most useful information you heard, and do you agree with everything we said? Do not hesitate to leave a comment down below, and press the like button if you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.